fuck with us. Well, we post it every Friday. See them corner emojis, then you know a nigga wildin'. Jaded Gemini.
And shit's unreal though, because there's been so many attempts on this man's life that have been unsuccessful. And it always gives people like the illusion that somebody is bulletproof. But all it takes is like the right set of circumstances.
Yeah.
And that's all it took, bro. That is literally all it took. They knew bro had his favorite spot. Shit. The fucked up part about it, though, is when I heard they just had opened a newer location in the city. But bro, so down to earth, he chose to go out of the way, be in the hood, show love before the turkey giveaway that he was about to do. And, like, just like on some... I'm not even gonna say it, but very similar to some Nipsey shit where it's like you in the hood helping out, boom. Yeah, only difference, he had beef for sure though.
Yeah, I don't know. I heard about this when I was doing a live stream, and then as soon as I got off, I was looking up and see what was going on. I was really surprised to see that people were immediately like saying Soulja Boy did it and like just pointing fingers at rappers, and like Dolph is like an older rapper. Like he's not beefing like with like the way the young ones are type shit. Like, and if he was beefing with somebody, we wouldn't know about it. Like, I don't know. But
he was beefing with Soulja Boy on he wasn't even really beefing on, with like, Soulja. It was fatal really
shit though. Glock, like, you get what I'm saying?
That was just having words with him, and bros the boss of their shit, and then they were talking. Yeah. But he really used to have a prehistoric motherfucking beef with Yo Gotti, and shit, we were listening to the fucking song before we got on. He said some very, very choice words on that motherfucker, where it's like, you know, some people probably wouldn't live him down. But like you said, with him being such an older gentleman at the time of his passing, I don't see why now would have been the time where people, after all them other turkey giveaways, would have been, oh yeah, this is what we're going to do. Like,
so has he been out though since COVID?
It's hard to say, bro.
To his hometown anyway?
He shot major during COVID. Because didn't they say like around that time?
Am I tripping, or didn't they say like Memphis was one of those places that got hit hard by that shit?
He was out there. Mm. He was out there, bro. All his videos, he literally was just getting like all his camouflage cars and putting them bitches in the hood. Remember. Yeah, he was out that bitch, bro. And that was when COVID started. He kind of still was doing videos like that, but with less people type shit. But, that shit's fucked up, bro.
Well, here is the breaking news report here. And some more stuff actually came out today.
Yeah, bro. Somebody did some dumb shit.
Somebody got arrested.
Somebody. I ain't even gonna do that thing I usually be doing. I ain't gonna jump it today, bro, because this shit here is fucking ridiculous, bro.
Yeah,
they just really need to chill, and that the way people are acting is making me think even more that people that are older did not have nothing to do
exactly with that's this why dumb I'm ass like, shit, bro. I don't think this had anything to do with anybody that the public knows.
But I'll take this shit in, because there's a lot of shit I've been avoiding.
Yeah, me too. I haven't really been, yeah.
Tonight, we strongly encourage everyone to stay home if you do not have to be out.
The Memphis Police Chief is asking everyone to stay home tonight after rapper Young Dolph is gunned down and killed at a South Memphis cookie shop.
There will be extra police presence in many parts of the city that might have a connection to the popular rapper to make sure there is no more violence. Hello, I'm Greg Hurst.
Hi, I'm Stephanie Skirwalk. Adolph Robert Thornton Jr., known as Young Dolph, rose to...
Random, but I did not know his name was Adolph. Like, that shit has been catching me off freaking guard.
That's a very
but now it makes sense why he's Young Dolph.
It definitely attracted a large crowd to the cookie
store on Airways Boulevard. Many frustrated and angry that this could happen here. Tonight we have Team 3 coverage of that shooting, the investigation, and the impact he had on music and the community.
WREG's Melissa Moon begins our Team 3 coverage live from the crime scene on airways where police are still searching for evidence. Melissa?
Well, police have finally cleared this scene, but there are family members and fans here tonight. And as you can see behind me, they have boarded up the windows of this business that were damaged or shattered by gunfire. Police are asking for calm as they investigate this murder.
Man, why y'all got the babies outside?
Yeah, bro, nah, bro. People really fuck with this dude. I just like really solid.
Dolph says his son was going to be in a video with Dolph. Lots of fans flooded airways trying to get close to the crime scene. The crowd and cars at times too much for police. Police say young Dolph was inside Makita's around 12:30 in the afternoon when his gun went down.
Being from Memphis, from seeing that shit, and bro, be there all the time, shit.
And checking cameras in the area that might have captured the crime, but couldn't say what the shooting was about.
This was a shooting that occurred at a cookie shop, and we're just not sure what that motivation was, and it's a little bit too early for us to tell.
I really thought he would never come back to Memphis, so Memphis got a lot of haters.
Police provided an escort complete with sirens and lights.
Man, where the fuck have you been in Memphis?
Signature camo covered Lamborghini.
That is not a Lamborghini, bro. He does have a Lamborghini.
Senseless violence plaguing the city and nation.
Goddamn.
Our hearts go out to the Thornton family and all who are affected by this.
Oh, damn. He said, told my son when I die, he gonna be a rich little bastard. That nigga is about, bro. I don't know what Adolf had up his sleeve, bro, but you can rest assured, bro. That shit about to move and he was doing good before, bro. His people gonna be good, bro. Like, real talk. Real talk. That dude always been a fucking a little bit ahead of the curve when it came to, like, making shit move. Always.
Clues in solving a mystery in Memphis.
These motherfuckers,
who shot and killed young Dolph in his own hometown? This grainy photo released by police shows a person in gray pants and a dark hoodie with gun in hand, apparently firing. Also released a photo of a white car.
Damn. So, remember this picture.
That may be linked to the case. Police have not said where the pictures were taken, but all around Makita's Cookies, where Dolph was shot down, are businesses with security video cameras.
Surveillance video would be important to show exactly what happened here, and one camera should have caught it all. This one right above the door here at Makita's Cookies.
Someone
to step up and identify who is responsible for gunning down the young rap star. Just 24 hours after his killing, the crowd is still gathering outside Makita's Cookies. People who just want to be near the place, Dolph took his last breath. Austin Short parked his truck next door and blasted young Dolph's music for all.
That's what's up, bro. That's what's up, dog. Nah, for real, though. Fuck it, dog. Fuck that shit, bro.
I'm here to support him, play his music all day, and whoever comes up wants to enjoy it with me can, and, you know, we're just going to
D'Anthony Moore brought his young son to see where it all happened. He worries about the future for Memphis's young people.
Worried about maybe moving the area we decide to live in, stuff like that. Memphis as a whole.
The latest example of senseless crime in Memphis has many asking, when will it stop? Memphis Mayor Jim Strickland says the city is doing all it can.
Our problem, our challenge is state law is weak.
Nigga, don't try to flip this.
What the fuck? Right, what are you talking about?
And widespread access to guns, while at the same time not punishing the wrongful use of those guns.
But for those who knew young Dolph, the man,
I think it's a little bit deeper than that.
Yeah,
niggas have been getting banned for shooting guns for a long time. Y'all know what you're talking about. Weak for like
spot. He died.
Shit. I watched First 48, nigga. Ain't nobody getting no motherfucking.
To take him away, it's just a pain. It's a real pain.
That shit is in Memphis, bro. Like, y'all niggas definitely bamming people, bro. Y'all got hard enough punishments. Like, I don't think that's what needs to be done, bro. I think y'all tried that already.
What?
fucking giving out lengthy sentences for the use of firearms, bro. I think it's a little bit deeper than that.
Yeah, I don't even see why he even brought up guns in the first place. That shouldn't have happened.
That's like, what fucking, it's like, dude, the sky is blue,
he could have had a bat. Nigga. He could have had a bat. He could have had a taser. At the end of the day, he got caught slipping.
Apparently, like, he shot back and shit, bro.
That's what I'm saying.
I mean, there's certain things you could be as prepared as you want to be, bro. Your arms are way too short to box with God, bro. If it's, that's what it is, bro. If they got the drop, shit, we need a bigger gun? Like, what the fuck, bro?
Well, the question of who killed Dolph has been lingering. And like we said earlier, suspect number one via the internet, not law enforcement, but the internet, was Soulja Boy. So Soulja Boy came out on live and said his little two cents about the situation. And, I personally haven't seen it, but I heard that it's pretty,
I heard snippets of it, but I get the general consensus is basically, yo, I don't give a fuck, but that's not what really bothered me about this shit. The shit that had me like, bro, what the fuck is he dropped that damn song that he said he had it out for a minute when niggas checked him, but it's like, bro, you supposedly, quote unquote, like you said, internet beefing with niggas. They pass away and you even try to like inadvertently take credit for the situation or take cloud off of it by dropping a song about it. And it's like, bro, you, especially if you really toe tagging shit, like, I get, okay, that you don't fuck with people. You don't have to be, you know what I'm saying, wishing them off and shit. But bro, you can at least respect the dead. Let them rest, bro.
Yeah, like, you don't gotta be fake, but you could just not say shit at all.
Usually when people disrespect the dead, it's because they had something to do with it. And it was, they don't feel bad about
it. Right. Well, this is what he said right here. Hold on. I found the shortest version I could because the whole thing is a good, like, 30 minutes. So if y'all want to look it up, you can. You're more than welcome to. But I'm good.
Big. It's right, though.
Why?
This nigga here.
Why the change?
You already know why.
Never
give a fuck.
Help. Bruh. What the fuck is the point of this?
B Drake on 2, the album out right now, gonna run it up. And he ain't post my album.
Oh, so he has the album coming out.
He always has the album coming out, bro.
He does.
That's the point. And I get that you disrespect dead ops nowadays and the rap culture, but bro, that is not a good practice for one. And bro,
really
y'all
isn't.
Never
that
had no street
juju,
beef
bro.
In the fucking
oh,
first place, bro.
Shit.
Right.
That's the confusing. If it's street beef, fuck it. If you must. But this shit is internet as fuck, always has been. What the fuck, bro? What are you doing?
So you've seen this before.
No, I'm saying the whole...
I'm asking you a question.
No, not this.
If you ain't post my album, you a bitch, nigga.
Okay, because I'm about to say, bro, this shit is not entertaining to me. Like, nothing's happening. I was about to ask you if any of that looked familiar or if I should look for something else, because...
I feel like I've probably seen 2 seconds of that before, and all he was saying on that second is like, yo, I don't give a fuck about none of that shit. Niggas was talking about fuck me, basically. Fuck that shit. And that's, like I said, I don't care about that. Because that's like, whatever. But when you start making songs and shit subliminally and all that shit, it's weird, man.
Yeah. I just want to know what the fuck he said. But I just don't feel
like... That's on their money game block.
I don't feel like cherry picking nobody fucking live. Like,
pretty sure this is it.
Hey, what chain y'all think I should put at the top? This one?
Oh, my God.
Or this one?
I think it's the nonchalantness factor that's really...
My thing is, I don't see him
too.
Saying shit. I feel like...
He's gonna say shit. You're being impatient, but it is a
I'm
long...
Sorry,
time.
I'm being impatient, so but though. It's just so boring.
Yeah, that's usually how they are.
Like, bro, nobody cares about any of this shit, about your mask.
What color y'all want? Stores, all stores. Know what I'm
Bruh, I feel like this nigga just trolled everybody. I don't even think he said... Did you really hear him say anything? Be real. Did you hear him say anything?
I have. Very, very vaguely, though. Like, that's what I'm saying. That's the nature of the beast with this other shit. But I know for a fact, that's why I'm really just reiterating on this song that mm-hmm. he already had out. And he acknowledged that. But it's like, smoke some or some shit like that. I'm just like, bro, why the fuck would you drop a... Your dumbass went out and either already had a video shot or you went out and shot a video to a song about smoking some shit. I mean, I'm sure you already have 1,000 of those, but nonetheless, you chose to drop it the day after this nigga passed away.
I know, but he was already dropping music. I feel like the timing was just ass because he was just on the Breakfast Club talking shit. That's why people are even doing this. That's why people are like, oh, he killed him. And I'm like, bruh, no, he did not. And then that live had absolutely zero shit going on, bruh. Like, I just skimmed through different parts of a 30-minute live. And he talking about more Soulja gear. Soulja mask. Soulja this, Soulja that.
Let me ask you this. Do you think that he thought people were going to speculate that that's what he was referring to and that's what he was talking about, especially, do you think he's totally in a state of naivete?
No, he's aware the internet is talking about it. That's why he went live.
And kept but doing I'm just saying,
I feel like people online are taking, because he is dropping an album, that this was like premeditated type shit. And it's like, bruh, I don't think that he like... recorded music, killed him, and I don't think that's what's going on.
Once he said, like, he has the album coming out, even though he always has one coming out, dog, you got an album coming out, drop your shit. But all I'm saying is always. When niggas checked him about that shit, he never even for once was on some peace mode. So I'm like, regardless of your intentions, nigga, you're in that situation now. And I'm not saying that you can't shoot have 100 shooters in Atlanta or whatever the fuck, but this nigga had a gun.
Yeah.
Apparently he was shooting back. I mean, definitely RIP, but shit, bro. Why even do all this shit? Like, that's what I'm saying. You're just not really learning from this this process here, I guess.
Well, there's been an update to the case. At the funeral or...
The vigil. Yeah. Candlelight.
Yes, at the vigil. Mm-hmm. There was a drive-by. Like, literally, all this stuff happened within, like, 3 days.
Yeah, no time has passed. Like, this shit just happened, for sure.
This is all happening within 3 days, but 3 people have been arrested for that. Not the shooting itself, like him getting shot at this place, but the vigil shooting.
Literally, these niggas did a whole nother incident,
a whole nother crime
that technically still involves him. Because, right. Like, it's so fucking stupid. Like I said, this is what makes me think that when people are like, oh, Yo Gotti has something to do.
This seemed local as fuck.
If he did, this is a diversion, goddammit. What the fuck is this dumb shit?
Right.
In this space of remembrance for young Dolph, many come for different reasons, some to grieve, others to pay tribute.
I just really want to stop by here because I kind of feel
just innocent people,
you know, with his family going through.
But after 2 shootings in less than 48 hours, one witness we spoke with who did not want to be identified is left shaken.
My life was in danger because I don't have anything to do with it. I'm just really just... I'm preparing my respect. And it was like, Lord, I can't get killed. I can't get shot because I'm a grandmother.
A man was shot in the thigh Thursday evening. Memphis police believe Terrence Jones pulled the trigger from the backseat of a stolen vehicle as he rode past the vigil. Well, shortly after the shooting, MPD officers say they chased the vehicle.
You think he gonna talk? Because you know it's related.
If it is related in some way, hell yeah, he going to, bro, the pressure's on now,
the
bro.
The pressure is on.
I told y'all, they got first 48, bro. All this might even be televised. Like, that's how the fuck they work, bro. Like, y'all must have forgot you're fucking with A&E, bro. Like, you must have forgot. Like, all I'm really thinking right now is just like you said, if this is connected, they're doubly fucked now.
But do you think he going to tell? If it's connected, I think so.
I don't think he's gonna have to. I'm pretty sure they got all of them niggas.
One of them, somebody.
They're about to try their hardest to make them believe that regardless of what the fuck happens, they're gonna get pinned with that other murder. Mm-hmm. And I don't know what. Remember, I think 1090 Jake was saying, hella motherfuckers were getting shot. I don't know the validity of that or whatever, but bro, there's been a lot of shooting going on.
Yeah, over this.
They have definitely confirmed 2 and 24 hours on this video, but like, damn, bro. Somebody's getting banned for this shit. Six sure.
Pure Avenue and Mississippi Boulevard and found the car wrecked. APD says Jones and two other individuals took off running from police and were ultimately caught. MPD recovered 6 guns and one of them is believed to have been stolen.
They better hope one of them guns don't come back.
Out of six?
Two.
I feel like one of them is. I think, like...
They better hope.
Why would they... Like, what was the reason?
You can't even shoot 6 guns at one time, my nigga. Why didn't you just have, like, two?
What was the reason?
Three max, or you could just, like, boom, boom. Like,
why?
Boom, or boom, 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 boom.
Well, there were three of them, so they had two each?
But that's stupid. One of them got to drive. Right. But it's crazy when there are three niggas when Dolph got shot. Wasn't there? Because two niggas hopped out. Had to be a driver, you would think.
It was two.
The police and got me custody.
That's three, right?
And I'm glad that they did that because they could have shot innocent other people up here.
Since the shooting, Memphis police have added surveillance cameras and increased patrols in the area. Reporting in South Memphis, Jordan...
If what 1090 said was true, which I'm pretty sure it is, given his track record, y'all should have been put them motherfucking cameras up, shot spotters, all that shit.
Right.
All that shit. Like, I don't know where the disconnect is. Like, shit is real. It's real. It's going to remain that way for real. Until they either solve that shit or for the foreseeable future.
Well, that's all the updates that we got on it so far as of November the 20th. Hopefully more stuff will come out. Hopefully we can find out, are those the three that were involved with the original shooting? Were any of those guns used in the original shooting?
They did tow that car. You didn't show. I remember that car, that white car, too.
And I'm like, was that white car what they were in?
I'm pretty sure that was the... It was like an E350.
Man, hold on. Because now you got me over here curious. Was it in this video?
I believe it was
in... I'm over here telling other people to remember.
It was in like the first one that we watched, love.
No, I know, but I'm seeing... This is the one that came out today. I'm seeing if the one that they were caught up in, but it looks like they're not showing the cars.
Yeah.
But... Even if it... Oh, no. This shit's silver. Nah, that's
a Stolo.
Yeah, this shit's silver.
Yeah, they said that shit was stolen.
They did say the car was stolen.
That's a Stolo.
I think it was them, bro.
Stolo.
I think that shit was them.
Splat.
I think it was them. But we'll see. We'll see. We'll see. I'll be patient.
First one was probably Stolo, too.
Yeah, we will see.
Do that shit.
Rest in peace.
Definitely rest in peace, Dolph, bro. So fire, bro. Longest,
this was so unnecessary.
Most fire discography that you gonna find, bro. Go listen to his shit, bro. Definitely every song gonna ride on that shit, bro. These niggas slide, bro. Definitely slide.
Dismissed.
That's the whole reason we watched that fucking scary shit in the first place. I feel bad whoever had to leave, because... That's the real motherfucking travesty right there. Like, what in the fuck? Y'all seen this shit firsthand.
Oh, my God.
Nobody else gonna see that.
The prosecutors told the judge they did not think the charge of abuse of a corpse was constitutional in this case. Case against a fourth member, John Robertson, is expected to be dismissed this afternoon. A coroner was not able to determine how Carlson died.
Wouldn't that be grounds to not dismiss?